My name is Luis Vargas. I'm a principal program manager in the SQL Server team. I work with Azure to make sure that Azure is the best platform in the world to run SQL Server. So I'm going to show you a demo how easy it is to open a free trial and start using SQL Server and virtual machines in Azure. So let's check the demo. The first thing to do is open a free trial in Microsoft Azure. You can do this at azure.microsoft.com. Here you can start a free credit of $200. And after this, we can go into the Azure portal, portal.azure.com, and create a virtual machine with SQL Server. So you can see here I have a free trial. And all I have to do is go to New, Databases, see All Feature Apps, and there you'll find SQL Server. Here you will see the list of all the different images that we have for all the versions of SQL Server and all the editions of SQL Server. Given that this is a trial, I'm going to start with the free license SQL Server Developer Edition. This means that I won't have to pay any SQL licensing, and I simply will pay for the cost of running the virtual machine. So I'm going to start with SQL Server 2016, SP1. I hit Create. And I'm going to specify some basic information for the virtual machine. For example, my SQL Server virtual machine. I'm going to specify the type of storage. So I'm going to select SSDs as the fastest storage. The name for my administrator. A password. Then the resource group, which is just a logical container for the resources that I will create inside of Azure. So I'm going to say my resource group. And then the location. So we have many different locations around the world where you could create your virtual machine with SQL Server. So we're going to select West US in this case. Next, I will select the size of the virtual machine. So there are many different sizes, right? I can select View All and see even a longer list of virtual machine sizes. In this case, I'm going to select DSV2, which is a small virtual machine with just one core and 3.5 gigabytes of memory. So I'll select this one. Now there are many different settings associated with the virtual machine. For example, if I want to create an IP address that is available over the internet, I'm just going to select OK. I'm moving to SQL Server settings. Here, you will find the SQL Server configuration for your virtual machine. You can specify how to connect to SQL Server. For example, if I want to connect from my laptop using SQL Server Management Studio, I will select Public. Then the port where you'll connect to SQL Server. If you want to authenticate to SQL Server using a specific username in SQL, so in this case, given that I'm going to connect from a different domain, I will specify authentication with SQL Server. Next, you can configure the storage. So I'm just going to use the default storage, which is 3200 IOPS, 48 megabytes per second, and 1 terabyte of storage. And finally, I could configure automated patching, for example, if I want to patch SQL Server and Windows at a specific point in time, and automated backup, if I want to automatically take backups for my SQL Server virtual machine. I can specify to keep my backups for 30 days, to encrypt my backups if I want to, 2 backups and databases, and also to specify when exactly I want my full backups and log backups to be taken, or if I want SQL Server to decide for me. So I'm going to select this. And here you can see a summary of all the settings that I have specified. I have a virtual machine running with SSD drives. It's going to have SQL Server 2016. The SQL port is going to be 1433. I'm going to enable SQL authentication to connect from a different domain. And I'm going to have 1 terabyte of storage. Automated patching is enabled on Sundays at 2 in the morning. Automated backup is enabled as well, and my backups are going to be kept for 30 days. At this point, you can click OK. And in approximately 5 minutes or so, I will have a virtual machine running SQL Server that I can start using. Now that you have watched the video, take advantage of the $200 free trial on Azure, spin a free SQL developer image, and finally, try SQL Server on Linux. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you find it useful.